G'day mates, Hada BBQ here. So this is going to be a dusting crafting guide so that you have a little bit of guidance about what cards you can safely dust. Now, first things first, in your collection you need to set out your goals. What do you want your collection to do for you? And you really need to be thinking ahead. Say, in 6 months' time, what do you want to have out of your collection? Do you want a competitive deck for every archetype? Do you want just one competitive deck? Do you want to have a complete collection? You need to know what your goals are before you set out, because if you ever dust something and craft it again later, that's going to be so costly. This guide is going to go through what are the cards that you can safely dust if you have the goals of just making competitive decks. Now, if you want competitive decks in all classes, then you can only dust the things that are not competitive in all the classes. If you're only interested in some classes and not other classes, then hold on to the competitive cards in the classes you're interested in, and the classes that you're not interested in, you can just dust everything if you like. But this is going to show you those cards that you can safely dust, because we have the benefit of time, and see which cards are actually good. So, let's jump in with the legendaries. We have, so of mention is Nat Pagel and Tinkmaster Overspark. These two here used to be prime candidates for competitive cards, and then they got nerfed into oblivion. We've also got some dragons down the bottom end. Now, we have had a bit of time with Blackrock Mountain. Blackrock Mountain has the dragon theme, and a lot of cards get more powerful with dragons, but these cards down the bottom, your Nozdormu, Onyxia, and Deathwing, have not made the cut. Sometimes you see Deathwing played with, you know, competitive players will play Deathwing just on a whim, but in general, you just shouldn't do it. And the rest of them are going to be quite good in Arena, but not really that competitive. Mind you, that said, you will find that if you have in your collection something like a Foe Reaper 4000 or a Trogzor the Earthinator, or even to a much lesser extent, a Hogger, and you're really only playing in those lower ranks, these cards are still going to be quite high impact. So quite a few of these you can still play in the lower ranks, but I wouldn't recommend them playing in a tournament or in the higher ranks. And the same is going to be true for Gazlo, Illidan Stormrage, to a lesser extent, Mechagnir Thermoplug. Quite a few of these are playable at those lower ranks and will be effective, but you can safely dust them if you're only interested in competitive decks. Let's have a look now at the epics, the neutral epics. There's not that many epics, and most of the epics are actually quite good. Here are some junk, featuring Junkbot as well. A little proviso, however, Murlocs were once competitive, not really competitive anymore, but they are a lot of fun. You will also get an extra card if you collect one of each Murloc. So you will get the legendary Murloc if you have one of each Murloc. So you might, if you are interested in getting that legendary, you might want to keep one of each Murloc, get the legendary Murloc unlock, and then dust all the Murlocs after that. Also, South Sea Captain. Pirates are rubbish at the moment, but over time there may be more competitive pirates. Unlikely, but possible. So you may want a South Sea Captain later if there are a whole bunch of competitive pirates that come out later. But there are these you can safely dust. Let's have a look at some rares. Quite a lot of junk rares. So you have a lot of joke rares like Angry Chicken, Target Dummy is. I mean, you can try and run Target Dummy in a mech deck, but it is really a joke card. You've got those Murlocs, as I said before, and you've got quite a few cards that are going to be good in Arena, and not really that good otherwise. There's a few fun cards, like a Llama Bot. Maybe you want to just have a Llama Bot around to have a fun deck going. But otherwise, none of these are particularly competitive, so dust them as you will. Let's have a look at some commons. And again, the commons, quite a few of these are good in Arena, but not really in your competitive decks. And things like Dancing Swords, I wouldn't run if I had the option ever. Let's have a look at some classes, starting with the Druid. Some interesting cards here. Druid has some, so Savagery was a card that was quite powerful before it got nerfed. You've got some cards that don't really do anything, like Soul of the Forest. Volcanic Lumberer shouldn't actually be on this list because you can't dust him. My bad. Mech Bear Cat, though, get rid of that. And Malorn is not really that great. The only time that you'll see Malorn in competitive games is when Hunter gets it off a Web Spinner. Naturalize has been played sometimes, but I don't think you ever should be playing Naturalize. And if I'm wrong about that, it's only uncommon. But I would go ahead and dust it. Let's move on to the Hunter. Sad Hunter. Sad Hunter has two legendaries that are not very good. Unfortunately, now, King Crush is super, super powerful, and the same is true of Gazzarilla, but they're expensive. And expensive is not really what competitive Hunter has ever done. So competitive Hunter has always been aggressive, and probably always will be aggressive. It's got that hero power that tilts it in that direction. So if I was you, I would go ahead and dust those legendaries. But you know, they're pretty cool, they're pretty powerful. I think a lot of especially newer players will be allured by the potential power out of these two and just kind of just jam it in a deck and play it on the lower ranks of the ladder, and that's totally fine. Go for it. But if you're looking at climbing to the higher ranks, if you need that dust to craft up other competitive decks, I would start with those legendaries and look at all these epics that are just not very good. Feign Death, Bestial Wrath, Steamweedle Sniper, and Gladiator's Longbow have all proven themselves that it's not that great. Gladiator's Longbow has seen play in some competitive Hunter decks, but it does cost 7, and honestly, Hunter should be capping out at about 5 or 6 most of the time. Let's have a look at what else we have going on. In the Mage, wow, look at this. Look at the proportion of awesome cards in Mage that you've only got 4 auto dusts. That's crazy, that's crazy. Yeah. These cards are just not very good. Dust them. I don't think I really need to justify that anymore. Let's see. Have a look at the Paladin. Also true of the Paladin. You've got no epics that suck in Paladin. There you go. A couple of rares and some commons. So you're not going to get a whole lot of dust out of this. These cards are not very good. And they're not good in Arena either. So that's pretty simple. Let's have a look at some Priest. Shadow Form, you know, you can make Shadow Form work, and again, that's one of those cards that's going to be quite good on the lower ranks of ladder, but I wouldn't recommend it at the higher ranks, and it's really unfortunate. Shadow Bomber would be amazing in another class, but in Priest is pretty rubbish. Lightwell, especially on the lower ranks, you might see Lightwell combo. This involves building up the health of your minions and doubling the health and then turning your health into attack. Lightwell is a card in that, and so is Lightspawn to a lesser degree. The deck is not good, but you can win ranks lower down on the ladder, and it is quite fun. Mind Games, again, is a fun card, but yeah, I'd dust it. I'd dust it. There are better fun cards than Mind Games. Next up is the Rogue. So quite a few junk epics here. Kidnapper, what a disappointment. What a shame. What a shame. Cogmaster's Wrench could potentially be playable if there are better mechs that will go into a Rogue deck. But for now, it's not that great. Patient Assassin is certainly not worth running. And again, so Iron Sensei is going to be in the same boat as Cogmaster's Wrench. If there are more and better mechs for Rogue to give you more options, Cogmaster's Wrench and Iron Sensei could be better than they are now. So you might want to hold on to them. The rest, pretty solid. Dust them up. Master of Disguise could be potentially a combo piece in a later time with cards that are not yet created yet. But I think it's pretty safe to dust that as well. Let's move on to the Shaman. The Shaman, look at all these epics. Now, I have a soft spot for cards like Farsight and Ancestor's Call. Man, those cards are pretty fun to play with. Not very competitive. So if you need the dust, I dust them. But I'm holding onto my Farsights and Ancestor's Calls just for a little bit of fun every now and then. If I don't want to play a competitive deck, maybe I just want to play some huge dragons and things and play Ancestor's Call. Maybe a one-turn kill with Malagos would be pretty sweet. Siltfin Spirit Walker. again, is a Murloc. If you want to build up a Murloc deck or to get the Legendary Murloc, you're going to need... I think you only need... Do you need only the Murlocs out of the Classic set, actually? So Siltfiend, Spirit Walker, I don't think you even need there. So maybe just dust it. Maybe just dust it. Next up is the... What classes are we running up to? The Warlock? Yes. Yes, the Warlock and their love of demons. Sense Demons is still not worth it, unfortunately. Sorry. You've got the hero power that draws you cards anyway, so why do you need to jam some demons into your hand? It's just not worth it. Not needed. Blood Imp used to be better than it is now. And you've got Felguard and Pit Lord were never really good. Summoning Portal, again, you could have a janky fun deck, lower ranks with Summoning Portal, but it's only a common, so you're not going to get much dust out of it, and it doesn't cost much dust to craft. Up to you. Last class is the Warrior. You're not going to get a whole lot of dust out of the Warrior, unfortunately. If you want to build competitive Warrior, unless it is Patron Warrior, it's going to cost you a whole lot of dust. So the Control Warrior being at the top end of the dust requirements. But here's some janky stuff. You're not going to need any of these for Patron Warrior or Control Warrior. So dust away. And that is all the classes, all the neutral cards. I'm going to leave the lists here so you can click links to see all of these lists. So you can just double check. Go through your collection. See, just to make sure if there's anything you can craft quite simply. This is just to save you a little bit of time if you're looking in the future to have competitive decks. Go for it. Use these lists. It's very, very safe to dust any of these. Yep. This is certainly... So anything that appears on these lists, I have dusted myself, and I have access to every competitive deck that is currently available. So you can trust. You can trust. Until next time, I hope it's been informative. I hope it's going to help you out with your dusting. And until next time, thanks for watching.